Still more than a year away, but right now central Indiana is getting ready for the moment. Our sky will look like this. Central Indiana will be in the path of a total solar eclipse on April 8, 2024. Now this map behind us is from the Indiana Department of Natural Resources, and it shows how we're in the zone of totality for this eclipse, where the sun will become almost completely dark.
And we hope to show you that map in just a bit. In the meantime, along the center line, you'll finally see darkness, and it will last about 4 minutes. The total eclipse, the last one that we saw here in the U.S., was in August of 2017. So you may remember some of this video here from places like Indianapolis, people wearing special glasses just to make sure they could look up safely into the sun. Now, we aren't in the zone of totality, so the moon did not completely cover the sun, but it did somewhat cover it. But in April 2024, our view will look much more like what people saw in places like Kentucky, South Carolina, and Wyoming. They were able to see the moon going right in front of the sun.
Pretty fascinating. That means many of our local communities will also be welcoming tourists who are interested in seeing this rare celestial event. In 2017, states like Nebraska, Oregon, Missouri, and South Carolina experienced a big bump in tourism that August and had parties where people could gather and watch the eclipse.
Well, local communities in central Indiana already starting to plan for that process to make sure they are ready when a similar surge likely gets here from eclipse chasers.
Yeah, Fox 59's Max Lewis tells us what we can expect here in Indiana and how some are already making changes ahead of the big event.
A total solar eclipse is a breathtaking experience.
It's just so otherworldly, if you will.
Keith Turner is the planetarium director at Carmel Clay Schools and traveled to Kentucky to see it firsthand back in 2017.
As you get near totality, the temperature drops 10 to 20 degrees. Birds and bugs are confused. It gets really dark.
He showed us what Hoosiers will see next April when the eclipse path goes straight through Indiana, and the crowds it's expected to bring with it are almost as amazing as the eclipse itself.
We're expecting in the greater Indianapolis area, including Carmel, 500,000 to 2 million extra people.
That number of people overwhelmed many communities, including the one Turner traveled to.
Even though there were signs put up, don't stop on the interstate for eclipse, people just pulled off on the interstate and stopped.
That's why preparations are underway right now and changes are already being made. Tonight, the Carmel Clay School Board unanimously voted to change their spring break next year so that students won't return until the day after the eclipse to avoid the expected crowds.
We're covering every detail from do lights need to stay on when it's total eclipse to how many glasses do we need to order?
Visit Hamilton County has formed an organizing committee for the event. Since the eclipse falls on a Monday, they're hoping tourists will make a weekend out of it and pack local hotels. They're already scouting sites for watch parties.
Places like Hunter Prairie, Grand Park, Ruoff Music Center.
Back at the planetarium, Turner is just hoping that on April 8th, 2024, the weather will look a lot different than it did today.
If you want to see it live with your own eyeballs, this will be your last chance and through central Indiana.
All right, and there's the map back there that you can see that we weren't able to give you a look at before. It shows the path going right across central Indiana. Well, Visit Indy and Bloomington's Tourism Bureau also told me today that they are starting discussions on getting ready for this pretty big event as well. The big thing that you're going to need is these right here, these eclipse glasses. It's pretty dangerous to look at the eclipse until the sun is completely behind the moon. I'm going to put mine on here, Dan and Beerschel. You see them right here?
I like that.
I can't see a single thing.
I can't see
you guys.
We're waving
nothing.
At you. You don't
yeah,
even see
yeah,
us,
right. That's the important thing. These became, pretty hard to find back in the
hot
2017.
Hot commodity.
They were. They were going for like, $30, $40
right.
on Amazon.
It became a hustle. Eventually, people were like hoarding them and then selling them on these
and
sites.
And you've got a pair. And I have a pair. I have a coveted pair of glasses. Our friend at the Carmel Planetarium gave them to me.
Nice.
They're going to be a hot commodity, so they said get them sooner rather than later. We're going to maps on the eclipse if you didn't catch it there, where to watch, where to get some glasses. All that's going to be on Fox 59.
We're already planning amazing coverage, so we can't wait.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
It'll be fun.
April 8th, next year.
There you go.
Thanks, Max. Appreciate it.
Thank you. All right, well, believe it or not, you may actually also want to start planning ahead for this eclipse. As Max mentioned, it is a major event. Many people outside of Indiana will be here. I think we should have home dibs, first dibs here, because it's going to be in our backyard. So you want to prepare. Indiana DNR says that they do have a list of approximate eclipse times at their properties. Lake Monroe will be in totality for about 4 minutes just after 3 p.m. Fort Harrison State Park will be in totality for 3 minutes and 49 seconds, also around 3 in the afternoon. Now, the view won't be as good in places like Turkey Run State Park, where the total time in totality is only about 1 minute and 25 seconds. But there you go, three different places where you will be able to see it. And again, prepare April 8th, 2024. The nation's highest court will soon consider